Hello students, today we are going to study transportation problem. So we are going to calculate the initial basic feasible solution for the transportation problem using northwest corner rule. So our problem is here. Okay, so in this problem we have three sources, namely A, B and C. So these sources produces this much quantity of products. So A produces 250 quantity, B produces 300 and C produces 400 units of homogeneous same product only they are all producing. So their aim is to transport all those product to four destinations, namely D, E, F and G. So these four are destinations. So for this destination D, they required only 200 units of the product. Similarly, this destination E requires 225 units and F requires only 275 units and G requires 250 units. So this is the basic concept of our transportation problem. So inside I gave some values. Those values are known as cell values or caste matrix. So what is meaning of this 11 means? To transport one unit of the product from the source A to the destination D, we need 11 rupees. Likewise, the other things we can assume. So this is the basic problem of transportation problem. So our aim is to find the minimum transportation cost to transport the unit from some sources to some destination. So that is our main aim. We need the minimum transportation cost. So for that we can use three types of method. One is northwest corner rule and another one is least cost method, and third method is Vogel's approximation method. In short form we can call that one as VAM method. So for the same problem I am going to find a solution using these three methods. So initially, for every transportation problem, we have to verify whether the given problem is balanced or unbalanced. For a balanced problem only we can solve using any type of rule. So how to find one problem is balanced means you have to find the sum of availability. So sum of availability is denoted by the letter summation AI, that is this column values, that is our available value. For this available we are going to find the total. So it is 250, 300 and 400. So totally we have 950. So this is our sigma AI value, and then we have to calculate a summation BJ, that is the sum of our requirement. This row value we have to find the total. So it is 200, 225, 275 and 250. So addition of this value is 950. So in this case both summation AI and summation BJ are equal. Therefore this given problem is known as balanced transportation problem. We can find the solution further. So if it is unbalanced, we have to do some modification to change the given problem into balanced one. Now we are moving to the solution part using northwest corner rule. So for that northwest corner rule, we have to take the northwest element of the cell matrix. So northwest element is for initial table, the element is nothing but 11. So we are going to fix 11 for some values. So 11 is present in this first row and first column. So in that row your availability is 250, but our requirement is only 200. 100. So among these two values, we have to find the minimum value. So for this 250 and 200, our minimum value is 200. So we have to fix that minimum value for this cost value 11. So 11 is fixed by 200. So all the requirement of this D destination is satisfied. So no more requirement is there. So fixed value is subtracted from both requirement as well as from availability. So 200 is subtracted means this value becomes 0 and this value becomes 50. So our requirement is satisfied for D destination. Therefore that destination should be deleted. That is, which column or row corresponds to 0, that row or column should be deleted. Here D column has the value 0, therefore it one should be deleted. So here we deleted the D column. So our first table is over. Now we are moving to the second table. So our second table is like this. So we have three destination EFG and three sources ABC. And our availability values are, for first row it is 50 and second row to 300, 400 and here 225, 275 and 250. So again on, in our cost matrix we have to select the northwest corner element. So northwest corner element is this element 13. So for that 13 our availability is 50 and requirement is 225. So among these values we have to fix the minimum value. So minimum value is 50. So for this cost value 13, 50 is fixed. So we fixed that 50, therefore we have to subtract both availability and requirement by this fixed value 50. So this one becomes 0 and this requirement becomes 175. So for this source all the availability is over, therefore no more availability is present in source A, therefore this source A should be deleted. That is the row which has 0 availability is deleted. So row A is deleted. Now we are moving to the third table. So in third table we have only two sources, namely B and C, and three destination, namely E, F and G, and our availability and requirement values are follows. Again we have to choose the northwest corner element, which is 18. For this 18 our availability is 300 but requirement is only 175. So among these value we have to fix the minimum value. So minimum value is 175, which is fixed for this one. So fixing value is subtracted from both it is in this one is in first row and first column. So that values, that availability and requirement should be subtracted by this fixed value. So 300 minus 175 is 125 and 175 minus 175 is 0. So this destination has 0 requirement, therefore that destination should be deleted. That is row column E has 0 value, so that column should be deleted. Now we are moving to next table. It has two destinations F and G and two sources B and C, and our availability is 125, 400. Here we have 275 and 250. So again cost matrix, we have to select the northwest corner element, which is 14. So for that 14, here our availability is 125 and our requirement is 275. So among that least value we have to select, which is 125. So that is taken for this cost value and subtract that exact fixed value from both availability as well as from requirement. So this availability becomes 0 and this requirement becomes 150. So this B source availability is over, therefore source B is deleted. So now we are moving to next table. It has two destination and only one source, and our values are 400, 150 and 250. If any table has only one row or one column, then we can fix the corresponding value there itself. So this 13 is fixed by 150 and 10 is fixed by 250. So our all the terms are over. So we can calculate the total transportation cost. So in first table, we are taking 200 units with unit cost 11 rupees, therefore total cost is 200 into 11. In second table, we are taking 50 units with unit cost 13 rupees, so total cost is 15 into 13. Here 175 into 18, 125 into 14, 150 into 13, 250 into 100, so 10. So multiplying all those, then you get your total cost is like this. So this method is known as the northwest corner method. So in northwest corner method, only thing we have to remember means in each table we have to choose only the northwest corner element, which is the first element of the table. For that we have to find the minimum value of requirement as well as available, which is minimum we have to fix. So that is the main procedure. This is one easiest method. So under the this method, our total cost is these much values. So now we are moving to one more method. That method is known as least cost method. So for same problem, I am going to find least cost method value. Okay, so for this least cost method, among cost value, so cost value means inside one matrix we are given with some values. So those values are known as cost values. So among cost value, we have to select the least cost. So our least cost is this 10. So for this 10 is appeared in two places. For the second row 10, our availability is 300 and requirement is 250. For this third row 10, our availability is 400 and requirement is 350. In any 10, we have to fix only the minimum value, which is 250. Okay, so I am arbitrarily selecting this 10. Okay, I hope you understood what I am telling. Okay, so if we select any 10, then we have only this 250 as the minimum value. So I am taking this 10. So this 10 is corresponds to second row and fourth column. For that we have availability is 300 and requirement is 250. So among this minimum value is 250. So that 250 is fixed. And if one element is fixed, then afterwards you have to subtract that element from both availability as well as from requirement. So 250 is subtracted means this value becomes 50 and this one becomes 0. So in G destination, all the requirements are satisfied. So no more requirement is possible for G. Therefore, G destination should be deleted. Otherwise, which column has the value 0, that column should be deleted. Here, G column has 0 value. Therefore, that column is deleted. So we are moving to the second table. It has only three columns, namely D, E, F and three rows A, B, C. And our availabilities are 250, 50 and 400. Here we have 200, 275 and 225 and 275 are our requirement value. So among least cost method, so among cost matrix, I have to select the least cost. So my cost values are here 11, 13, 17, 16, 18, 14, 21, likewise. So among that value, this 11 is the least one. So 11 is present in first row and first column. So we have to find the availability of first column and requirement of availability of first row and requirement of first column. So here our availability is 250, but our requirement is only 200. So among this value, we have to take the minimum value. So minimum value is 200. So that is fixed. And fixed value is subtracted from both requirement as well as availability value. So this 200 minus 200 becomes 0 and 250 minus 200 becomes 50. So this D column has no more requirement. All the requirements are satisfied for destination D. Therefore, that column should be deleted. So D column is deleted in this table. So now we are moving to third table. It has only two columns and three rows, and our availability and requirement values are like this. So among the cost value, we have to select the least cost because it is the least cost method. So least cost is 13, 17, 18, 14, 24 and 13. So two values are here, same values, which is least cost, that is 13. So for this 13, here we have 50 and here we have 225. So among that, 50 is the minimum. But for this 13 means here we have 400 and 275. So we have to fix 275. So better we can use the minimum value. So minimum value is corresponds to only for this 13. So I am selecting this 13 for my next fixed value. So for this 13, we are fixing the minimum value 50, and that fixed value is subtracted. Then this one becomes 0 and this one reduces to 175. So this source A, all the availability are over. Therefore, source A should be deleted. So we are moving to next cost matrix. In that cost matrix, I have my values, cost values are like this. So among the cost value, 13 is the least one. So for this 13, this 13 is present in second row and second column. So your availability is 400, but requirement is only 275. So among that, minimum value we have to fix, which is 275. Afterwards, as usual, we have to subtract that fixed value from availability as well as requirement. So this value becomes 0 and this one reduces to 125. So F column has 0 requirement. So that column should be deleted. So we are moving to next table. It has only one column and two sources. Previously I told if any table has only one row or only one column, then we can fix the corresponding element there itself. So this 18 is fixed by 50 and 24 is fixed by 125. Okay, so our total transportation cost in each table, we have to multiply the multiply the cost value and things. So this 250 into 10, here we have 200 into 11, and here we are buying 50 units with the unit cost 13. Here we are going to buy 275 units with 13 as unit cost, and 18 into 50 and 24 into 125. So after calculating, we arrived our total transportation cost using this method is 12,825. So this is known as least cost method. So next method is the very effective method. That method only gives the best solution for initial basic feasible solution for transportation problem. Okay, so that method is known as Vogel's approximation method. If in exam the method name is not mentioned, means best you have to use this Vogel's approximation method only. That one gives the best solution. So this is very interesting method. So same problem, we are going to find a solution. So how we have to proceed for this method means, in each row we have to select the least and next least element. So here for the cost value, so for the first row least cost is 11, next cost least cost is 13. So among the least two least cost, we have to find the difference. So it is 13 minus 11, your difference value is 2. So we have to mention that difference in bracket, so 2. And then second row, again we have to select the least and next least. So 10 is least and next least is 14. So difference of that value is 4. Similarly, in third column, least is 10 and next least is 13. That difference value is mentioned within bracket. Okay, near to that row. So it is 3 as our value. Similarly, for each column also, we have to do the same procedure. So for first column, least is 11 and the next least is 16. So our difference is 5. So we have to mention that difference within bracket for the corresponding column. Similarly, for second column, the least is 13, next least is 18. So I am the difference is 5. And for third column, least is 13, next least is 14. So difference is 1. Here least is 10, next least is also 10 only, so difference is 0. So first we have to find the differences for each row and each column. That difference should be mentioned within bracket. Okay, afterwards, among the differences, we have to select the maximum difference. So here differences are 2, 4, 3, 5, 5, 1, 0. So among differences, our maximum difference is 5, which is in two places. So if we select this 5, then it is corresponds to D column. So for that column, we have to select the least value. So least value is 11. Okay. So for that least value, our availability is 250, but requirement is only 200. So among this value, we have to fix the minimum value, which is 200. Okay. So if we select this one, then this 5 I am selecting means, in that column I have to select the least value, which is 13. So here for this 13, our availability is 250. Here our requirement is 225. So minimum value is 225, but before we are considering, means we get only the minimum value is 200, isn't it? So this 200 is minimum when comparing with this 225. So I am selecting this 5 only. Okay, I hope you will understand. So for that is the main reason we are selecting this 5. Okay, so among differences, I am selecting the maximum difference. That one corresponds to D column. In that column, we have to select the least value, which is 11. So for that 11, availability is 250 and requirement is 200. So among that, I am fixing the minimum value, which is 200. As usual, that fixed value is subtracted from both requirement as well as availability. So this one becomes 0 and this one becomes 50. So we are omitting this 5 because of maximum value 225. Okay. So this destination requirements are fulfilled. So we have to delete destination D. So we are moving to next table. It consisting of three columns E, F, G and three rows A, B, C. So and cast values and availability requirements are follows. So same procedure. In each row I have to select the least and next least value. So for first row least is 13 and next least is 14. So difference is 1. So difference should be mentioned within bracket. Here least is 10 and then 14, next least difference 4. Least 10, next least 13, difference 3. Least 13, next least 18, difference 5, 13 and 14, difference 1, 10 and 10, difference 0. Okay, so among differences, I have to select the maximum difference. Maximum difference is 5. So 5 is corresponding to E column. So in that column, I have to select the least value. So least value is 13. So for this 13, where availability is 50, but requirement is 225. So I have to fix the minimum value. So minimum value is 50. So that fixed value is subtracted both from availability as well as requirement. So this availability is over 0 and requirement becomes 175. So source A availabilities are exhausted, so that source is deleted. So A is deleted. We moved with two rows, namely B and C, and three columns E, F, G. Same procedure. We have to find the first row least cast value and next least cast value. So least cast is 10, next least cast is 14. So difference is 4. And then second row least cast is 10 and next least cast is 13. So difference is 3. And then in this column, least cast is 18 and next least cast is 24. So difference is 6. Here 13 and 14, difference 1. 10 and 10, difference 0. So among differences, I have to select the maximum value, which is 6, which is corresponding to E column. In that column, I have to select the least cast value, which is 18. For this 18, we have availability is 300, but our requirement is only 175. So minimum value I have to fix. So 175 is fixed. That fixed value is subtracted both from availability and requirement. So this one becomes 125 and this one becomes 0. Since requirements are fulfilled, that destination should be deleted. So E column should be deleted. Now we are moving to next table. It consisting of only two columns, namely F and G, and two rows, namely B and C. So this is our availability as well as requirement. So as usual, find the least cast and next least cast. It is 10 least, next least is 14. So difference is 4. 10 and 13, so difference is 3. Similarly, for each column also we have to do the same things. So 13 and 14 is 1, 10 and 10 it is 0. So among differences, select the maximum difference, which is 4. That one corresponds to B column. In that column the minimum value is 10. For that 10, our availability is 125, but requirement is 250. So minimum value should be fixed. So 125 is fixed and that fixed element should be subtracted. So this one is 0 and this value becomes 125. So source B availabilities are over. So source B is deleted. So we are moving to next table. It consists of two columns named namely F and G, and only one row, namely C. So previously I told, if any table has only one row or one column, you can fix the corresponding element there itself. Since this table has only one row, I am fixing the corresponding element. So this 13 is fixed by 275 and 10 is fixed by 125. As usual, you have to multiply each cost value and fixed element, and adding you get the total cost. So total cost for this method is 12,075. So first method, northwest corner method, gives the value as 12,200, and least cost method gives the value as 12,825. But VAM method gives the minimum among the three values. This is the best value. So only we are telling this method gives the best solution. So these are all the previous methods.